Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm feeling a little bit of anxiety coming from you because many of you are overwhelmed by email. Well, that is what we are here to work on. Ask Dotto Tech is the show where you ask, I answer. And you have told me that email is a pain in the butt. Let's deal with that today on Ask Dotto Tech. One of the things that I am acutely aware of is the pressure that's brought onto all of us by email overload. We sometimes just get inundated by the amount of email that comes in. And if we let it get ahead of us, it can cause all sorts of pressure that we really don't need. Well, today on Ask Dotto Tech, we received just such a letter. It's from one of our subscribers to our newsletter named John, who says, "Not for the first time, I've been told that I am nearing my 15 gigabyte email limit with Gmail. The last time this happened, I was on a deadline from hell and ended up temporarily starting a new Gmail account and using that with the intention of returning to the original site to delete the emails when I had time. That was years ago, and now I have two email accounts that are full. John, thou art an email hoarder. That's the problem, is you don't know how to delete email. Consequently, you filled up two 15 gigabyte allotments with Gmail. Don't feel bad. I know you do feel bad, but don't feel bad. And I know you feel stressed. I'm going to show you a couple of ways right now that you can overcome, that you can basically stay ahead of your Gmail. But before we do that, before we even consider ways to stay ahead, we have to figure out ways to catch up. How do you clear out all of that email in order to have some space? I don't think you should create a new account. Let's not do that. Now, you did mention here that that it's just too much work for you to delete emails. You said, for example, I selected a Groupon email in the search and I highlighted it, but when I pressed delete, it only worked 50 emails at a time. Common problem. Let's start there. Let's start with deleting email. Now, I have what to me is an inordinate amount of email. I've got a couple of hundred emails and maybe 1,000 in my inbox. But this isn't an unusual situation for many of you. Many of you have 10 times this amount of email sitting there waiting for you, mocking you. So let's begin with mass deletion of email. The first thing we're going to do is free up space. But every time we free up a little bit of space, remove these emails, we're also removing a little bit of pressure. We're also taking a little bit of pressure away from us. So if I want to, I'm in Gmail here, if I just want to delete all of these emails on this page at once because they are in my update tab, I don't really need them, they are old, and frankly, I'm never gonna get to them. So I go select and I go to delete. If I just hit delete now, if I just delete these emails by clicking on the trash, these 50 messages will go. But if I just look to the right-hand side here, this is what a lot of people miss. All 351 messages and updates will be deleted if I select that. So instead of just deleting 50 at a time, you can delete all that are in whatever search criteria you have. Now, when you delete them, you're only mostly deleting them. You're not completely deleting them. What's happened is they've actually been moved to trash. So they're still counting against my Gmail count, against my amount of storage that I have. And you can see that I've used up about 7% of my 15 gigabytes. So after we've gone through and we've deleted all of the email that you want to delete, John, then you need to go into your trash bin here. And usually you'll get to it by clicking on the more settings, because a lot of us have a lot of different things in our, a lot of different categories in our email. Go to trash, and when you open the trash, you can delete all the trash by clicking on empty trash now. And that's going to free up even more space. While we are here, if you have spam filters turned on, which we should all have turned on, let's not leave this until we delete all of our spam as well. Now, our spam filter is something that you should actually pay a little bit more attention to as well, because the odd time something valuable actually gets caught in the spam. So if I go into my spam filter, what I do is I will typically just scroll down looking at the names on the left-hand side, seeing if there's anything that actually might be legitimate email. And I don't see anything at all. I very seldom find anything, but the odd time you find something. Nothing at all there. So I'm going to delete all my spam messages now. So I'm going to click delete. and they are all being deleted as well. So there, I've just cleared up some space. Now, if I go through this process and go through and clean up my old messages this way, far more effectively than just doing it 50 at a time, then you should start to see a real change. And actually, we see that I've actually cleared up about 3% space just by deleting my spam messages and those other messages. Now, as well as that, as well as looking for the low-hanging fruit, the easy-to-find messages, you can also find repeating messages. You mentioned the Groupon messages. If they aren't categorized into an area that's easy to delete, you can also pick similar emails. Let me see. I've got a series. I've been getting a lot of email because of something that I've set up with Twitter. Let me just find the example. Here it is. Did you log into Twitter from somewhere new? So this is Twitter actually checking me because I've got a couple of automated services that are working with Twitter. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to copy that title and I'm going to paste that title into my search. And now when I search, look what I got. I got all of those messages that I would have to go through and manually delete. So if you've got, you can do this from an address from or to or a subject line. If you've got a lot of email in that space, you can quickly delete it all just by selecting it all here. And once again, select all the messages with this search and delete it. And of course, we'll want to empty our trash bin as well afterwards. So now we've moved all of those messages into the trash. So we are now continuing to clean up space as we go. Now, with a lot of these sorts of things where you've got repeating messages that you really don't care about, you're going to want to go through and basically unsubscribe from newsletters. There's a tool called unroll.me, which we've talked about in the past. I'll probably do a video on in the future, but it combines all of your newsletters and helps you to unsubscribe. But it sounds to me like in a case like John, that he's got a lot of newsletters that he signed up for and unsubscribed from very few. So you're going to want to make sure you go through and you unsubscribe. It's going to be a process. But each step that you do is going to get you a little bit closer to success. And here is the reason that we want to stay ahead of this email and reduce the amount coming in. Because email overload creates a unique type of pressure on us. When you have a full inbox and you've got email that's kind of what we call below the fold, when you've got more than, say, a single page of email to deal with, what happens is you know that that email is there. And even when you close the email down, your brain, because it doesn't trust that you're going to go and find something that's on the second or third page, tries to remember it. And it creates something that they call an open loop. All that it means is that you try and remember with this wetware here what's happening in the hardware there or in the software there. So instead of being able to relax and say, oh, I've got it, I've got everything under control, your brain says, oh, I have to remind Steve that he's got that email on page 2 that he should deal with, and it creates stress. And a lot of the stress that we have in the workplace comes from this email situation. Because typically an email, we have responsibilities, obligations, we're going to be letting somebody down, or we've got opportunities that we're missing. So we feel obliged to do these things with these open loops, and that stress becomes very real. And so personally, I think that one of the biggest things that we can do to reduce our stress load is stay on top of email. And the way you stay on top of email is by having what we call inbox zero, which effectively means that you don't have any emails that are unaddressed, that everything, that you've got kind of white space at the bottom of your inbox. And when you do, it is a wonderful feeling. Now, there's lots of techniques. If you do some search on inbox zero, you're going to find lots of techniques. We've got a free tutorial on our site about inbox zero, but the essence of it is once you get ahead of it by doing the different techniques that I'm talking about here, once you get ahead of it, then you want to touch it once. When email comes in, you want to deal with it immediately. And we've shown you tools like Boomerang and other ones that help with that. But you want to reach that goal. You want to kind of attach a goal to yourself of only touching an email once. When you open it, deal with it, get it out, either trash it, reply to it, send it to somebody who's going to deal with it, basically defer the responsibility to somebody else. But you want to take an action on every single email, and that way you stay ahead of it. I've got obviously some catching up to do, but it won't take me long because this is more for show than for real. The last tool that I want to show you is another one called Find Big Mail. Now, this one here is a tool that will go through, and this deals specifically with the issue that John was having with having too much email in his account. what this will do is it will go through, and it could take several hours. I'm just showing you the basic setup here, and it's a free service, although they like you to donate if you find it valuable. But they go through your email, and they find all of the large attachments so that you can delete those large attachments, again, saving you space. So all of these different tools combined are going to come together and help you deal with your email overload problem if you're in the case of John. But John, I got to tell you, hoarding email is the same kind of problem as hoarding in real life, as people that hoard in their home. It's something that you have to get ahead of. You have to get into the mindset of deleting email, getting rid of it, and not worrying about losing it, or you're going to constantly be dealing with this. Every couple of years, you're going to be dealing with this stress of having to catch up. Plus, you've got the issue of having lost all of this content, an opportunity that's buried in your email that you will never find again. Take a look here. Find Big Mail is just completed. It's found my 20 largest emails with between 15 and 34 megabytes, the attachments. So I can actually go here and I can take a look at what emails have my largest attachments, and I can clear up a massive amount of space just by dealing with these emails. Isn't that awesome? So those are the tips that we had. I hope you found today's video to be useful. Usually on this show, we answer more than a single question, but this single question probably requires more than a single show to even answer, because email overload is such a big issue. There's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. The second is subscribe to our newsletter. Then you hear about all of our upcoming webinars, tutorials, and workshops, as well as any news coming from Dotto Tech. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site supported through the generosity of you folks through the crowdfunding site Patreon. I encourage you to drop by our Patreon page, take a look, see what your funding means to Dotto Tech, and what perks are available to you should you become one of our patrons. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.